sausage on that. Did you eat any of that?
Uh-huh.
Oh, the sausages. Some guy said they, a friend of theirs handmade some.
Yeah, I remember.
Oh,
I talked to their team manager. And, yeah, I got to get in there and get some. Emma brought me some cookies. Okay. Thank you, bro.
Yeah, get some of that pasta before. Boy, they scrape fast here. You barely get time to.
I know. Did you drink water or anything?
Oh, I'm good. Thank you.
Yes, last year we did a thing on that.
I'm trying to go. I'm going to go. All right, I'm with you with the Capitals hockey here. As
we won that game too, right?
Yes.
That's what the
All right, we are underway with the varsity or JV matchup here. Just trying to get things situated. I should have done this during intermission, but I get talking. All right, shot on net and by the Capitals. Capitals wearing their purple jerseys going straight at us. It's kind of to my right as we're at the opposite end of the rink here, looking down at the far side of the rink. Capitals wearing their purple jersey and these Flyers wearing their gray jerseys. See, what else can I tell you? I'm not sure who's in net down there for the Capitals. I'm waiting for him to turn. Looks like Wadden. Jack Wadden's in net for the Capitals. All right, JV action underway. 13:50 left with the first period, 0-0 hockey game. The Flyers bring it down into the Flyers into the rink. Back to play it is. I gotta get the card, cheat sheet out in front of me. We have some new players out here, and I'm not quite used to all their numbers yet. At home, we had the names on the back of the jerseys, and it was pretty easy, but. As I see Jackson Webb out there, number 24 for the Capitals, I want to say Ethan Rose that played for the Capitals a few years ago. So Flyers with it down in the corner, chasing after it is Webb. Jackson Webb. Jackson Webb with it at the blue line. Number 24 for the Capitals, picked off by the Flyers. Flyers turn and move it back the other way. Helping out was Drake Davison, number 5 for the Capitals. And the puck goes all the way down into the Capitals into the rink, in behind Wadden. Back up against the near boards, out to center ice, and the Capitals pick it up at the logo at center ice, dumps it down into the Flyers into the rink, chasing after it is LaPrade. LaPrade centering pass out front to Tanner Gay, and the puck comes free. Flyers pick it up in behind their own goaltender. They move it on the far side, down into the Capitals into the rink. Are you doing the camera the whole game, Scotty? You should put the headset on you. Want the headset? We are going to set Scott Kruger up with a headset here, I do believe. Puck goes all the way down and keeps it down into the Capitals and in the ring. And I just got to find all my cords here as we set up Scott Kruger with on the mic. He's always fun to talk to. And we're going to get a whistle as Wadden covers it up. Gotta find one more chord here. Shot on net, save. Cooper with a shot on net. And the Capitals have it down in the Flyers into the rink. Sorry, guys. I should be trying to get Scott Krueger set up here on a mic. Trying to. All right, getting there. Puck goes all the way down, and the Capitals in the rink. Shot goes wide past Wadden. And we're going to get a whistle. Go, Scotty. Can you hear me?
Hear you perfect, Tony.
Awesome. I did it. Well, cameraman Scott Krueger, original head coach for the Capitals. Scotty, nice to see you.
Nice to see you, Tony. It's my first game on the radio. I'm a color guy for the Iowa Wild.
Yeah.
I haven't had a game yet, and the Bucks hit me up, Ben. So I'm going to do some color for the Bucks too, but first games with the Capitals with you, so lucky me.
Well, Ben at the Buccaneers is awesome to deal with, and he is he's an up-and-coming announcer, and hopefully he gets his shot real quick with the AHL or NHL team, and I think it's just a matter of time. He is awesome to listen to. Puck goes out of play, and the play is blown dead.
I couldn't agree with you more. I had coffee with him a couple weeks ago with the offer and said love to help. Just schedule's a little tight, and Caps are in town, Bucks out of town. You know that
yep,
schedule better
I know
than
that
anybody.
Schedule.
And then Wild on that, so I probably pretty much do the weekday games for the Wild, but excited for Ben. He's going to get some shots here with the Iowa Wild, I know, coming up because Joe O'Donnell is going on a California tour with the Minnesota Wild, I believe the 7th of November for 4 or 5 games span.
Capitals win the faceoff. They draw it all the way down, and the Capitals into the rink. Down below the goal line, Capitals pick it up on the far side. And I'm sitting here talking to Scott Krueger, and I am blessed and awesome to see Joe's number out there with a great shot saved by the goaltender for the Flyers. But what not a better person to wear number 38 to bring it back out of it was set idle for a couple of years here. And Brian Noga gets the honor of wearing that 38 jersey. That's pretty cool. I know you guys are friends with Nogas. And
yeah, even the rookie parents, right? They
yeah.
didn't take care of us, huh?
Yeah.
I know Joe was pretty excited about it, too. We had some verbiage on that. And then fun stuff out there. And this summer, Joe's girlfriend is from Chicago. So they went to a Cubs game. And he says some guy about 20 yards behind him is yelling, Joe, Joe. He's in Chicago. There's a lot of Joes.
Yes.
Well, it happened to be Noga. He's there celebrating his 21st birthday.
So awesome.
They had a good time celebrating.
Awesome. So, yep, Joe Krueger, you guys knew here listening. He was a Capital player I don't know how many years ago, 2 or 3 years ago. And Noga family out there, former Capitals too. And honored to get Brian Noga into the draft this year and pick him up, but kept him in the Capitals family and picked up the 38 jersey and the number. And so it's tough for me to look out there and rattle off Brian Noga's name when I see 38 out there, but I'll get used to it and get it right most of the time this year. Shot towards the net, just went wide. Not much action going here, but kind of back and forth. I think the players are getting a feel for each other here. Scott, is this your first time to this beautiful arena here?
No, I've been here a couple of times. Betsy reminded me because her memory's a lot better than mine. I coached Clark when he was playing AAA, and then my brother Brad reminded me Joe was here. I can't remember what Joe was doing, what team it was on, but he was there, and Brad said he went bar down after checking a guy hard. So, been here a couple of times.
Not too many places you come, and just probably 30 feet to our left is an Olympic-sized swimming pool. I mean, we got ice on one side and a swimming pool on the other side. Shot on net saved by Wadden. So, the YMCA here put a great arena here, a great ice arena here, and a beautiful swimming pool on to the left. So,
well, great facility. Football, I saw.
Football,
baseball outside, and this rink's a great rink. And I don't know if you tried the pasta yet here.
No, I haven't. I got to get back there and get it.
Oh, you're crazy. Great sauce. They got a plain sauce and a meat sauce. They're top shelf. And I yelled back at Betsy. I said, we got to make sure we bring Fremont to the chili cook-off game. And they were at the last one. That's
yep.
why we got the free food
yep.
tonight. So
puck's coming all the way. Yep, sorry.
Thanks to you.
Puck comes all the way down into the Flyers into the rink. Shot on net by DiCarlo, saved by the Flyers goaltender. We're going to get the first penalty of the evening to the Flyers.
A little slash on Brunell is what I saw there. Charles had a pretty good first period. He's been moving around pretty good. Seen a couple shots out of him. That line's working pretty well. It was him and Colby in the varsity game. Who was the third guy with him? I don't think it was Cooper.
Can't remember, Scotty.
Okay.
Pickett Finch Creamery, proud sponsor of the Power Play tonight. Guys, look for that logo all over your local grocery stores, and awesome chocolate milk and ice cream and all that stuff comes with the creamery. So look for Pickett Fence Creamery out in your local grocery stores.
As you said, that chocolate milk is special.
Oh, brother. My gosh.
I've had that before. That's good stuff. Can't find it. Can't beat that.
That the great family, locally owned. The whole family, mom, dad. I don't think they have one brother, I think. Dad, sisters, you see them all in the grocery store stocking the milk and going around all the local grocery stores and go out to their farm out in Granger. They take awesome care of you. Shot on net, save. Loose puck right out in front. Shot save again. And right on the side. Keep going. And they thought the whistle had been blown, and it wasn't.
Well, we had a good shot in the camera with that, Tony. I can tell you that.
Let's see here. My screen's all froze here, so hopefully.
Well, I hope they see it.
Yeah, they'll see it. I think the broadcast's going. Capitals bring it back down, and the Flyers in the rink on the far side to play it. Myers going to be a tired boy after today, and he's had a lot of ice time already. Right out in front, nice pass, centering pass, shot, save, and Charles Brunell with a shot on net. A nice save by the goaltender.
I'm on the air, Clark. You mind?
Clark Kruger coming up. What's up, Clark? Going to go in and get some pasta?
It's fantastic stuff. The meat sauce is homemade. Get deep. I think they're at the RV for a second. Checking out the dogs.
Face off to the stick side of the Cyclone goaltender. Capital. Not Cyclone. I knew I was going to do it yet tonight. The Flyers goaltender. Capitals with it on the far side. Noga right out front, tipped in front, and the Capitals score! Number 24 for the Capitals, Jackson Webb with the power play goal, and the Capitals make it 1-0 hockey game.
Wow, nice face off win there, Tony. Got on the power play and then went straight over to Noga, and boy, he's a very nice pass there across the line over there. Webby had a nice spot outside the paint and made it look pretty easy.
Yeah,
and if they're watching, the camera view is pretty darn good.
That camera guy's doing awesome.
So let's get back that chocolate milk so I can go out to the I can go out there and pick it up from them.
You can pick it up from them right out to Granger.
All right. And I know I've picked it up at the Windsor Heights IV.
Yes, you have. And you go out to the farmhouse out there on a Sunday. If you follow them on Facebook, they have a free sample Sunday, and it's 12 to 4 out there on a Sunday once a month. And go out and get your belly full of chocolate milk and ice cream and everything else that comes good with the creamery out there. Capitals with it down and deep over to play it as Noga. Noga gets hit down and across the goal line. Nice hard hit by Jackson Webb, and he bounces right back up. These Webby boys can play some hockey, and the younger brother is playing some tough hockey tonight. Shot saved by Wadden, and the puck comes free. You ever heard that boy play the piano, Scotty?
No. He's got some game, does he?
He's got some game. My goodness. Jackson Webb, he doesn't like to talk about it, but I've seen videos of him playing that piano. I asked him if we got an organ at the Buccaneer Arena, if he'd come up and play it. He didn't think he would. Shot on net, saved by the...
Well, you don't ask, you tell, Tom.
Yeah, Flyers. Picked off by Wiersma. And the Flyers bring it up through center ice. Capitals pick it off. Send it off on the far side. Down and deep it goes by Jackson Adams. Jackson Adams getting some games in as he comes back from football. He was one of them I was talking about in the varsity matchup as some of these boys come back from football and they think they're in good shape. But I know Scott will tell you, I remember your brother, one of Mark or Nick, was telling me, when he played for the Bucks, I said, how long does it take you to get out of shape if you get injured? He goes, the next day. These guys definitely use different muscles for hockey and what they do for football. They think they're in shape when they come to the ice arena, but they find out very quickly that it's a different kind of in shape than football is.
Yeah, that hockey kind of, I think, is similar to the cycling, that type of wind, than versus the running and the hitting out there. But I'm definitely a believer that the football definitely helps them be better team players around and playing multiple sports and probably quicker than playing nothing than coming back into shape, right?
Yep, exactly. You're 100% right.
So, Tone, I've been out of town working for quite a bit here on the weekends and catching Kristen in K-State, going up to see Joe in Iowa City. What is the football situation after yesterday?
Well, we have one. We're trying to get back, and we're not trying to get back. I hope he wins a championship. Paulus is the only one we don't have back yet. Let's see, who else do we have?
Makes sense. I got a couple extra Pepsis at the RV left over tonight. It's probably why the Paulises aren't here.
Yep, she's been listening and watching and wadding with the save down there. And Tommy Collins is he's back from football but has a football injury, and he's nursing an injury and should be back in action here in, I think, 2 or 3 weeks. So,
who did Tommy play at this year?
Tommy plays for Ankeny Centennial.
He said that. I talked to him. I saw the boot on.
Yep.
You bet. Boy, he got bigger.
He got bigger. And
he's already big.
What a nice family that is. Capitals with a face-off to the stick side of the JV goalie for the Flyers. Shot wide. 5:22 left in the first period of the JV matchup. Capitals keep it at the blue line. Sent over to the far side. Laprade with it. Or actually Brunel. Brunel with it. Left there for DiCarlo. Out there with Cooper. On the near side, the player to Brunel. Brunel on the half-board shot. Tipped. And Brunel comes up with it. Right out in front. Oh, boy, had DiCarlo set up. He couldn't get the puck to settle down. And then the Cyclones dump it up out of the defensive side of the ice, up through center ice. And the Capitals come in offsides.
Well, this line's had some about nice 5-6 shifts. A good first period anyways. They've been playing hard, working it there. Real nice pass by Barnell over to DiCarlo, as you said. A little bad bounce, but nice opportunity for a one-timer there. How's the Scott family doing?
Scott family's doing great. Just great. I know Mama went to the Buccaneer game tonight.
That was 3-3 last I looked.
They ended up winning 5-4. So.
Love it. All right. Bucks are doing well here lately.
Yeah, they do well at home. You just got to get some road wins going.
Lincoln, that sound right?
Yep, Lincoln. And the puck went up into the Flyers bench, and the play is blown dead. 4:29 left in the first 1-0 hockey game.
Wild had up 2-0 late, I believe. You get a final on that one?
No, did not see that.
I'll check that
on the
you.
Wild.
I got my phone on me.
Capitals win the faceoff. They draw back to Bellis. Bellis down in the corner over to Noga. Noga has it. Centering pass right out front. Shot save. And that was Drake Davison. Gosh, I can't get that number down in my head. I want to say Felker every single time. But, gosh.
Drake's a real good hockey player, very skilled. He'll be a name you won't forget here in a bit.
Capitals with it now. Shot towards the net. Just went wide over to the far side to play. It is Webb, Jackson Webb. Off to center ice to Bellis. Capitals really controlling this game. The play has been down in the Flyers end of the rink most of the period. I know these guys were excited to get on the road, excited to start a regular season play, did some preseason action. It's not quite the same as a regular season game. We start this the Tuesday or Monday after State Fair when it's about 110 degrees outside doing dry land, and it's just amazing how quick these guys have got into shape and shot just went wide, and some of these guys were hurting after. Most of them work for the Campbells during the fair, and long hours there and a lot of fried food and a lot of out-of-shape players when we started out in August, but I think it's came a long ways, and I know I was excited to see the regular season start tonight.
Season's here.
Shot save from the point. Baxter with a shot.
Yeah, I always think it's good for teams starting the road, Tony. I think it gives the kids an extra chance to get some chemistry, driving that bus together, getting a night in a hotel back there. And, you know, as far as parents, you get to siph out who you hang with.
Yep.
You know, that's why Betsy and I stay away from Dave and Carolyn Bettis.
Yes,
they're just bad people, you know. You kind of find out early instead of hanging with them.
Yeah, I see Super Dave in a Quick Trip every once in a while.
Yeah, and he just texts me, so I thought I'd badmouth him.
Super Dave. I miss seeing them guys on the road.
I don't miss them at all. Well, you know, the Wild, I told you, were up 2-0. They lost 3-2.
At home, or are they on the road?
They're on the road. They've had a nice stretch here. They won 2 on the road. They played Thursday, Friday.
Shot save.
I think because of labor contracts, they could play 3 games in a row. I could be off a day, but they've been hot.
Puck goes all the way down, and the Capitals in the ring. Chasing after it is Lanikin, Luke Lanikin. And the puck comes free. Cooper with it now up through center ice. Leaves it there for DiCarlo. DiCarlo on the foot race. Nice hustle by DiCarlo. Just not quite quick enough. Capitals have to touch up at the blue line, and the Flyers pick it up. 2:11 left in the first period. Caps up by 1. All the way back out to center ice. Flyers bring it down into the Capitals in the right. Nice. DiCarlo stayed with it. Forced the pass. Ooh, hard hit at the center ice line, and that was
Meyer.
Myers.
Had the pleasure of watching him play with the Midwest team for 3-4 weekends of those tournaments out there. He was one of the 4 Capitals there.
Yep.
Strong player. He's a nice addition.
Very nice kid, too.
Yeah, he's a wonderful kid.
We don't have a kid on this team that's not a very nice kid, as far as I'm concerned. We got a good group of kids. Shot on net saved by the Flyers. Puck comes all the way down into the Flyers in the ring. Back to play it is Jackson Webb. Webb out to Davison. Shot towards net, tipped in front by Webby. Capitals with it down below the goal line. 1 minute remaining in the period. Puck goes down and the Capitals in the rink. Capitals pick it up, dump it up out of the zone. Back to play it is the Flyers. Right on net, saved by Wadden. And here comes Capitals up through center ice. Bouncing puck. Shot on net, save! Logsdon with a nice shot on net.
Nice moves there too.
Capitals pick it off at the blue line and trying to get back to it. Couldn't quite get to it. It was Jackson Adams. Capitals pick it off right up front. Tanner Gay whiffs on it. Comes right back. Save. It came back to Jackson Adams there. And Capitals looking pretty good late with 9 seconds left in the first. Looking pretty good late in the first period.
Moving pretty fast here, Tom. Like the speed early in the season. Skill level. Seen my share of JV games. I like it.
Well, I know Chaney Smith has been working on their legs this year. Shot on net, save. Our Tri-Land coach, Chaney Smith, he's been making them do the ladders and a lot of leg work off the ice. And
Can we get Chaney to work a little more with Clark's legs?
Yes.
Tony, I just maybe a little more deeper in the squats. I see he's making all the way fold down on those.
And that got Clark out of here. He left. All right, 1-0 after 1. We're going to take a 2-minute break. Be back with second period action. Thanks for listening to Des Moines Capitals Hockey. All right, back with you, Des Moines Capitals hockey. Second period action getting ready to start here for the JV team. Capitals wearing their purple jerseys going to the opposite end of the rink of where we're standing. The Flyers will be coming at us as Wadden's in net for the Capitals right in front of us here. Set up at the end of the rink, but better than nothing. Capitals with it at center ice. We'll take pizza. Your son answered. They want pizza tonight, so.
Why aren't they eating that pasta?
I don't know.
Clark just came over here and told me that pasta was fantastic, so I don't know how much pizza they need. Tell them we're on a tight budget, Tony. We're eating pasta.
Yeah. All right, we had a...
We dodged a bullet
there. The horn went off.
Anyway, the puck came to the sideboard over there. It's kind of a little deal. We had a nice hit there, and then the clock kind of gave a little half-ass buzz, I think, on accident would be my guess. The referee then blew the whistle, and then it was a shot that, as that puck came out to the defenseman. They put it on Wadden, and I don't think he saw it, and then it went in the net. So
I'm good. I got two of them. Thank you, Tommy.
So I think it's waved off. It should be waved off, and hopefully puck outside. But
so I'm glad it's just not Buccaneer Arena that the clock just buzzes every once in a while. Face-off to the glove side of Wadden. Cooper with the face-off. Out there with Logsdon and Bellis. DiCarlo. Shot on net. Save! Wadden loose! And the Capitals, nice job clearing it away. And Brunell out there for the Capitals. Save again, Wadden. On the blue line. Back on the far side. Back to play it is Bellis. Bellis sets up in behind his own goaltender. Carlo couldn't quite stay on his skates. I've seen his dad do that every once in a while. Puck comes free all the way down into the Capitals end of the rink. And icing on the Flyers. 13:39 left in the second period.
Yeah,
not lying, am I?
DiCarlo, just moving. He wanted to get that puck. He's just a little quicker than he needed to get there. So appreciate the effort. No, you're not lying either.
Dave DiCarlo, we're making fun of him.
I'm thinking Mason City road trip.
Well, we got a Mason City trip. You going on that parent bus, Scotty?
You darn right I am. Last one for me.
Yeah,
well,
boy.
At least with the kid on the team.
You guys want a good time out there listening, whether you're on the got a son or daughter on the team or not. We are taking a Capitals bus up to a Capitals parent bus up to Mason City December 14th on a Saturday. Puck comes all the way down. Shot on net, saved by Wadden. And those Flyers have it on the near side. I can't remember how much it is. It's not very much. You jump on the CTI bus, opposite bus, and what the not the same bus the players ride on, but it's going to be a Capital parent bus, and a lot of adult beverages. They bring appetizers, and I hear it's a hell of a party all the way up to Mason City and back. I wish I was on that bus and not on the players' bus, but you guys will go ahead and have fun without me, and we'll see you up in Mason City that day. Save Wadden.
Up, during, back, and usually a bit afterwards on that one. It's a good time, and as Tony says, there's seats available, but for the Bettis family, we are sold out. So
yes.
I apologize.
Sorry, Bettis. So if you guys, anybody that's not on all of our emails, you want to ride that parent bus, my number's all over our Capitals page and my email, so get a hold of me, and I'll make sure I get your name on that list. My wife is even going up for that one. So
sweet. Kelly can sit with me and Betsy.
Here you go. Capitals win the faceoff. Send it off to the far side. Out to play it is LaPrade. He dumps it down into the Capitals ring, chasing after his Gay, and that's going to be icing on the Capitals.
Well, we haven't had a very good start, in my opinion, Tony, this period here. We took it to him, I believe, in the first period, and we got one goal advantage off it, I'd have to give Fremont the momentum so far here in the second period. We need to get this flipped around a little bit.
Face off to the glove side of Wadden. Capitals win the faceoff over to Baxter. Baxter sends it to the far side. Tanner Gay there to play it. Gay across the blue line. Back out to LaPrade. LaPrade brings it forward. Back out to center ice it goes. Capitals bring it all the way in. Shot on net. Save. Jackson Adam with a great shot. Great save by the Fremont goaltender.
He got behind those defensemen by a step. Looked like a semi-breakaway there. Did a nice job of bringing it across the far pipe. And a nice save and recovery by the goaltender there, who has the puck leaked a little bit back. Looks like we got a penalty on Fremont, Tony. I did not see that.
I did not see it either, but we are going to be on the Picket Fence Creamery power play at 12:05 left of the second period.
So tell me about this ice cream here. I know the chocolate
Scotty.
Milk. You struck a nerve, but the ice cream's legit, huh?
Legit. You ever had homemade ice cream?
Oh, yeah.
There you go. It is so good. They make all kinds of flavors. Shot on net, save. Strawberry is my favorite, but let's look for it. Not all places carry their ice cream that carry their milk, but most major stores in Des Moines carry their ice cream and milk.
So check your neighborhood.
Yes. Okay. I was telling earlier in the varsity game, we put their cream in our waffle mix instead of the milk or water, whatever you put in there, and oh my God, the waffles are to die for with their cream in there. Capitals with it, back to Bellis. Bellis over to Brunell, steering pass out front. Capitals working down in deep, back out to Brunell. To Bellis, fires it, shot goes wide, down to play. Just Bragg back out to Brunell. I like the way they're passing the puck here. Back to Brunell with it. Oh, just couldn't hang on to it. And the Capitals turn and bring it back down into the Flyers into the rink. 54 seconds remaining on the power play. 10:57 left in the second. Caps up by one. Shot on net, save. That came from Myers.
These big sheets of Tony, ice, Tony. I'd like to see these power plays take a couple steps inside. A prime example is there. You got Myers on the point, who's a very high steel kid. Bad bounces are bad bounces, usually after a second game, right? But if he's two steps inside that blue line and it bounces over, it really doesn't matter. You got all types of room, especially in a wide sheet, deep sheet, as we have here in Fremont today.
Face off to the stick side of the Flyers goaltender. Flyers win the faceoff. They draw it off on the far side. They're going to clear it out. 40 seconds remain in the power play for the Capitals. Logsdon with it. He sends it all the way up. Ooh, might be icing on the Capitals. Nope, didn't. Nope, yes, it did. Going to be icing on the Capitals.
So back to this waffle mix, Tony.
Oh.
So you got your own mix with the creams that you kind of do?
So I just do Bisquick waffle mix. You just put your egg in there and substitute. I think they asked for water or milk. I don't remember.
You go with the
creamery cream. Pick all a right. Fence creamery cream and
If you throw a little cinnamon in there, maybe you could throw a little, I've been using a little almond extract.
Oh, that sounds good, too.
Get a nice smell in there. It's not too strong for the kids, and it's a winner on that side.
Well, we did strawberry waffles last time. We used the Picket Fence Creamery strawberry milk and their cream.
Oh, I like how you're rolling.
Yes.
Got me fired up.
And
I'm
Kelly
a breakfast
put a
guy.
Little whipped cream on top of that. It was great. Capitals with it now, and we're going to get a penalty on the Capitals. Going to get a head contact here. I think that's going to carry a 2 and a 10. I think Baxter is going to send Ben Baxter.
Big boy.
Big boy. I think he's going to set for the rest of this period.
You bunch of an egg guy, Tone? You make a good egg or no?
Yeah.
Scrambled? How you roll?
I do. I did some eggs this morning, and I just do over easy on the eggs.
I like a nice over easy, too. I'd like to make a little stock, and then I roll my scrambled eggs in there with a light touch. I do a little mayonnaise, which is unique. But,
damn, we're going out the RV for breakfast.
You come on over, pal. I'll get you covered. But I put a little cream in my eggs instead of the milk when I scramble. Ooh. So I might use that creamery back at it, Picket Fence back at it.
All right. Pruny needs, you'll be impressed by his work. His company's doing fantastic out there in Waukee, and You'll catch some of his work next week as we open up our season at home. Tyler did the team pitcher this year, and he did the senior pitchers that would be hanging up on the glass at the south end of the rink. I seen on the flyers.
Doing some graphic stuff too, Tone, that type of stuff, the wraps and all that as well?
He has not. Somebody else asked him if he's doing the wraps, and he's not doing wraps, but he does just about everything else.
Okay. Awesome. And we got a three-day stand, game stand next week. Who we got in the house?
We have Mason City coming into the old barn on Friday night, and we're going to get a rematch with Lincoln on Saturday, Sunday.
That'd be a nice match up there. Let's go.
And so should be a good test for this Capitals team.
Well, I know Joe called Betsy Tuesday and asked if he'd come home. I'd had to be the reason. Catch 3-1, huh?
Yes. Capitals, or as Flyers bring it down, and the Capitals in the rink trying to wrap it around. Centering pass out front, picked off. Oh, boy. I got to say his name. Number 26 for the Capitals. I've been practicing on it. I just can't get it to roll off my tongue. Matt
Mazikowski.
There you go. I just can't roll it off, man. I'm
horrible at names, Tony. But I'm actually kind of pumped myself I can pull that one off.
They just said say it Maslow, but I want to get his name right so I can roll it off. I'll get it before we get too far into the season. The Flyers bring it all the way down, and the Capitals in the rink picked off by Cooper.
I know our clerks told us that Mazikowski, he's wearing 26, was Dan Carbom dressed.
Yes.
But they said his mannerisms, he's left-handed, the way he skates, everything, his body, his posture, he's got a lot of Dan in him.
Yes, he does. He does, and I have noticed that. And that's why when I look out there every once in a while, I will think same dress and same shot on net, saved by Wadden. Wadden with a fantastic save there, a little extra activity in front of the net.
Charles letting him know he was there.
Yep.
Little something, but not enough to make something out of it, I think, by the rest action.
Capitals win the faceoff. Cooper out there for the Capitals on the penalty kill. Out there, Luke Lanigan. Myers. And Brunell out there for the Capitals. Shot went wide past Wadden. Sent over to the far side. Brunell plays it off the half boards. Tried to chip it out. And the Capitals get it out. A little shorthanded try coming back the other way. DiCarlo. Not out of the box, but off the bench. Shot towards the net. I'm not sure that goalie got a piece of that or not. 5-on-5 hockey. He definitely looked behind him.
Always a good sign, isn't it?
Yes.
If you're on offense.
I tell you what, that goalie for the Bucks last night played a hell of a game. We're going to get a penalty coming up on the Buccaneers or on our Capitals here, as DiCarlo is going to go to send men, and the Capitals, DiCarlo is going to go in.
Well, DiCarlo did a nice job getting out of the box quick, getting down there to change that momentum after a penalty kill, and one of the reasons why we had an opportunity for a goal. Finished a hit in the corner, then came cross ice at that blue line. To make a big check. I heard the noise, saw the finish, but didn't get to catch all the math. Refs are talking. I think maybe optimistic here and ask for two, but it looks like a charging call so far by the ref. I don't like how these referees always ask the linemen. You know, if you're in charge, make the call, do there. If it's something you didn't see, then, right?
Yep.
Don't do it there. But he saw the play. Otherwise, he had his arm up. Why does he need to ask somebody else what was going on with that? I disagree with that.
All right.
The shop at, Tom.
So you know where Gilchrist Lumber is out there in Waukee?
Sure, great spot out there. Up by Q, new Starbucks out there. And so a lot of good restaurants.
So Tyler and his partner build a building out there, and they share it with Unity Point Healthcare out there.
Sure.
They are on the north side of that building.
Awesome.
Capitals win the faceoff, and I think it's just going to be a two. I didn't hear any turn of 10 at all.
I didn't either. I didn't see the door open up for a second person. So DiCarlo in for charging is what I didn't hear, but what I caught from referee signal.
Flyers with it in behind their own goaltender. Keeping up with it. Trying to see who that's. Bragg was keeping up with it. Puck comes all the way down in the Capitals end of the ring. Centering pass broken up by Noga. Back to play it is Bragg. Bragg putting the pressure on him. Here comes the Flyers up through center ice, picked off by Noga. Noga leaves it there. Puck comes all the way down right at Scott, and I Logsdon with it. He sends it across the ice all the way on the far side. Flyers pick it up down below the goal line on the left side of the ice. Nice penalty kill so far for the Capitals, and Logsdon gets a piece of it, sends it, I'm going to assume it's 200 feet the opposite direction. Bucks Arena is about 160 feet, isn't it, Scott?
I think so.
It's a little shorter than Lincoln Stars and the Buccaneers, probably the last two old rinks in the USHL. Shot on net, saved by Wadden.
Dubuque's new one's about the same size as those two sheets. You agree with that or no?
I think Dubuque's a little bit longer.
It's definitely deeper behind the net, but I'd be curious to see what the depth, the whole length would be. I know the length of Phil's.
Yes, you do. Shot on net, saved by Wadden. 5 seconds remaining in the penalty kill for the Capitals.
Well, 5 seconds with this and 5 minutes left in the period, Tom. We really haven't established any
momentum
in this thing, being short for the last 4 minutes, so dodging it's pretty good. We haven't really given up too many chances, but really when this penalty gets over, we need to change this momentum back to 5-on-5 and get a goal this period.
Flyers win the faceoff. They draw a back shot towards Wadden, just went wide, and Capitals are back to 5-on-5 hockey. Brunel comes off the bench as DiCarlo went to the bench for the penalty box. On the far side, Cooper with it. Flyers pick it up in behind Wadden. Cooper putting the pressure on him. Cooper has it now for the Capitals. Moving it forward all the way out to center ice. Brunel trying to catch up to it. Flyers dump it back down. Over to play it is Bellis. Shot in front of the traffic. Cooper has it in his breezers. He took a hard hit. Whew. And the puck goes all the way down into the Flyers in the rink. Shot on net, and the goaltender for the Flyers comes up big as it looked like Brunel cutting towards the net.
Well, nice play by Cooper there, keeping his head. Ref didn't see it
there.
He didn't have the puck and really got taken advantage there. And by his discipline, puck went the other end and got a shot and actually an opportunity to score a goal there. And hopefully we can start this momentum. Going down two more minutes wouldn't not be the answer here.
Coach Himmelson jumped online here. Coach Himmelson was not able to make the trip. He's a proud father. Stayed home to watch his daughter this weekend as his wife is working the evening shifts. And we miss you on the road here, Coach, and see you next week during practice. Hopefully you can make it out to the home games next weekend. And I know he misses it, but family comes first, and got to take care of business at home before you come out here on the road and play. So
those little girls are special.
On the far side, over to play it is Gay. Gay with it on the far side. Capitals with it now, over to Cooper, or Myers. And we're going to get a penalty here. We're going to get an interference call on the Flyers.
If I'd actually call interference, but definitely it's a penalty. The hands were a little high on Meyer there. That was my opinion, but I don't know he's actually calling it on either.
So we got to get the Little Debbie Snack Cake power play in this period. So Little Debbie Snack Cake power play. Nothing better than having a Little Debbie Snack Cake donut with some Pickett Finch Creamery chocolate milk.
Oh, Tony, I'm going to disagree there. I'm going to go with the chocolate milk with the nutty bar.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yes.
You can get the wafer there. You got two of them. You can go wafer by wafer so you can make that thing last.
I like that.
Break a stick by four and take it by the wafer.
I like that. I liked hearing the stories. I always hear stories out there working about how people eat their Swiss rolls and their nutty bars.
I'm a nutty bar fan, pal.
Capitals have it now down into the Cyclones, in, or the Flyers into the rink. Shot on net, save.
Looks like the intensity
is kind of picking up here.
All right.
Capitals couldn't keep it in. Puck goes all the way down into the Capitals into the rink. Shorthanded try by the Flyers, and Gabe Myers in with a hard hit, and another hard hit by Myers. And here comes Myers back at it. My gosh, and he paid the price there. And oh, back and forth, and now we got a fight. And Myers drew the penalty, and are they taking both or one?
I think just one, Tony. I think they're getting him for the headlock. Well, they're bringing two.
They're
going
to bring Myers in. Myers, you did nothing wrong there, man. He held his ground, and he's got put into the headlock, and they're going to call both. But
yeah, I apologize for those at home. I missed it here in the corner. I'm a good talker, but I'm not following with the camera, Tony.
Well, Myers has played a lot of ice today. He might need a little break, and he'll be fired up here when he comes back out after this penalty. They'll be back out at the 120 mark on a whistle.
As I told you earlier, I saw him play with the Midwest team that's gone around on four tournaments before the season started. And I think Gabe's only a senior, if I'm right there. He did a nice job competing against some juniors and seniors with a big difference in size there.
Capitals win the faceoff. Couldn't hang on to it. Puck comes free. Anna Dressen jumped on the Facebook. Hi, Anna Dressen. How are you?
What's up, Banana? I partied with her and her dad last weekend.
That's too bad you had to party with her dad, but that's
well,
all right.
It's good to see you, Anna, anyways. It's always good, bad with the good, Tone.
Sorry, Tony Dressen. Capitals have it on the far side. Left for Bragg. Bragg to Logsdon. Back to Bragg. Shot. Save. Shot. Save. Goal! Power play goal. I'm not sure who chipped it in there in front of the goaltender.
I didn't see the, I saw
it,
the goal.
I think it's Laprade.
I think you're correct.
I want him to turn it there. Is. It
yep,
is Laprade.
Correct.
Laprade with the power play goal. The Capitals go up 2-0. That's what Scotty was talking about earlier. Capitals need to at least get one here in the second.
Well, took advantage of the power play. It's nice to obviously score on those. We get the momentum back here and get another goal here for the second.
All right, face-off center ice. Cooper with the face-off out there with Laprade, Brunel. Maslow and Bellis.
Anna, we think Mazikowski looks like your brother Dan. Same number, same way he skates.
Yep.
Give us your opinion.
I just about called him Dan, too.
I'll take it on text or we'll take it on live screen. Yep. Your call.
Yeah, he does. The more I look at him, the more I think it's Dan Dressen out there. We just need some red shiny hairs shining out of that helmet. Face off to the stick side of Flyers goaltender. Man, it's been a long day here. What time did we start? 6?
6 o'clock.
Not too bad.
I thought the varsity game went pretty quick. Yeah. I had it over at 8:05. I thought the refs did a very nice job of keeping it clean and consistent.
Flyers with it. They bring it down into the Capitals in the rink. Picked off by Maslow. And here comes the Caps back the other way. Brunel with it. All the way down. Shot on net. Save. Nice save by the goaltender. Young man down there in net for the Flyers.
He's done a nice job so far. Haven't seen much action on him in the second period. The first period definitely in this end. Caps strong period.
Shot save again. Right out front. Rebound. Shot. Goal! And it might be Laprade with his second goal of the period.
It was, Tony. But we keep bringing it up front here and giving us some chances with a lot of rebounds there.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. What a turnaround here in the last few minutes of the second period. And the Caps are up by 3.
Who's in action tonight in the league, Tone? We got a lot of games. Full list out there today?
We probably do. I haven't. See if I can't pull that up here. I know the Oakleys were up in Okoboji, and they won pretty easily up there. Okoboji's going to have a tough year. They only have 15 players. That's including one goalie. And, Scotty, you know as well as I do, trying to play 15 players in a JV varsity league is going to be tough.
Well, the good thing is you won't, if you're coaching that thing, you're not getting many complaints about ice time.
Right, exactly. I never thought of it that way.
Yeah. And well, if you're the Oak Leafs, if you're going to hit Okoboji in the hockey season, I think you couldn't hit that any better.
Yeah, there's quite a few games going on here tonight. Maybe try to get through some of that during intermission. Flyers with it. And they couldn't hang on to it. Puck comes free. Oh, a hard hit right in front of the... Oh, and they're going to blow the whistle. And who's that down there with the Capitals?
Logsdon and Adams, I think it was.
Adam,
down
Jackson
there.
Adam.
Hit on Adam on Logsdon. I kind of was following the puck and not staying with there, but... seemed like the Fremont young man stayed on our guy a little bit. And
he's going to go to the sin bin.
Somebody came by and got his helmet off, so I didn't just come off on accident.
Yeah, he's not. Maybe not. They closed the door. But any time in this league, if your helmet comes off, the play is blown dead right away. If you watch USHL or even the pro hockey, your helmet comes off. And pro hockey, you continue into play. I think the USHL, you have to go directly to the bench. But in this league, the play is blown dead for the safety of the players.
You only got one melon.
Oh, boy. It's amazing to me that they used to, that the whole team out there, including the goalie, didn't play with a helmet at one time. So I would definitely not ever want to be a goalie without a helmet. Frick no.
Well, especially with that Bucks goalie last night. He stopped 52 of them? Is that official?
He stopped, put 52 on net. He stopped 50 of all the 52.
That's a busy day. And get a W.
And got a W. And
21 on the other side. Does that sound right?
Yep.
I thought I saw that in line last night.
And he got the first star of the game.
He should get it for two nights.
Yes, he should. Flyers with it at Sooner Ice. Bucks are fun to watch this year. Back on the Capitals end of the ice. Nice pass up out of the zone. No, tried to get it out of the zone. Couldn't quite do it. Maslow takes a hard hit right in front of us. Cyclones with it. Or Cyclone. God dang it. I keep wanting to say that. Flyers. Shot on net. Saved by Wadden. They remind me of Ames. That's why I keep thinking Ames little Cyclones. Capitals have it on the far side. Baxter comes up with it. Baxter moving down the right side of the ice. 16 seconds left in the period. Shot on net, saved by the Flyers. Bouncing puck at the blue line. Maslow with it. Back over to Noga. Kept in by Bellis. And then it squirts free. That's going to do it for second period action. And the Capitals come up big late in the second period with two goals. And are up by three, leaving the ice. We'll be back in 17 minutes with third period action. Thanks for listening to Des Moines Capitals Hockey. All right, back with you, Capitals Hockey. Third and final period for the JV team, as they will not go into overtime if it's tied after three, so it will be the final period. Capitals coming at us this time, wearing their purple jerseys. Shot on net save by Wadden, and the Flyers wearing their gray jerseys going away from us. And shot nice. That's a nice block by Bellis. I like that. It's old-time hockey there.
Yeah, early in the period, too.
Yeah. Nice play. All the way in. Shot on goal. Score! Brunell makes it look easy. Picks it off. Further down the ice, comes in, scoots around the defender, and 1-on-0, and Brunell just made it look easy.
You know, Tony, that just shows you what happens when someone swallows a shot there, right? Bellis comes out, blocks his shot there. Charles is the recipient of picking up a rebound. Coming down, and he showed a skill level. Came down with some speed. Shoot a couple guys, came in, and I think it was backhand bar down.
Right? I think it was, too.
Yeah, so I heard the tink, and I saw it down, and I think it caught a little bit of the celebration. Boy. I got Amber Myers messing with me here. Tone sends me a text. Her kid's going to get in a headlock. She'd like to see it on the camera.
So yeah.
I think it's been positive for the kid. Amber, I saw her at the preseason game with Lincoln, and she had an incident happen. I'm gonna own my word and just stay quiet, so I'm a little surprised she's kind of poking at me, but I'll let it go.
I'm not sure what you're talking about, but I'm sure you'll let me know. Wadden with the save for the Caps. And on the far side to play it, Flyers couldn't keep it in. I think that's going to be an unassisted goal, too, for Brunell, Charles Brunell.
Well, Bellis should get one for the
shot. Oh, he did. Okay.
Came out. Well, I don't know if he got one. He deserves one, right?
Yeah, he probably does.
Deserves two. You take you block a shot in the gut.
We'll see if he gets one or not. They haven't put it up there yet. Is it? Well, we're gonna have to get that change. They got Beckett LaPrade down there for the fourth. Is it 5-0 or 4-0?
Four on the board. I think it's 4-0, bud. We got two. Yeah, it was 1-0. We got two at the end of the second. And Charles just got.
They have the score 4-0 after three or after two periods.
Well.
Huh. So what? I don't.
Sounds like they did a little pregame.
I don't know. Yeah. Anyway, we'll see what happens, Steve. Anyway, Capitals are winning. I think it's 4-0, but I don't know why they got it still in the second. We'll have to get that fixed before they close it out. Puck's all the way down, and the Capitals into the rink. And over to play it is, Jackson Adams.
It's tough at that far end, isn't it?
Oh, buddy? It is. Well, my mind goes to Lanikin there, so.
Yeah, new set of jerseys,
yep.
Set of names.
Yep.
Same jerseys, I should say,
yeah.
New names and numbers.
Yep. Back to play it is Adams. Adams with it. Turnover by the Caps. The Flyers didn't take it down into the Capitals end of the rink. Shot on net. Saved by Wadden. Steered off behind the net. And we're going to get a whistle. Going to get a
penalty
slash.
Away from the play. I didn't see it.
Be a slashing for sure.
Like on 17 or 13, Talon. I couldn't see a jersey was tucked
was it,
in.
Is it on the Capitals?
Yes, sir.
All right. Tyler's going to get some love here. Give him a call and make sure you mention the Des Moines Capitals. Tyler will give you the Des Moines Capitals discount. And I have no idea what that is, but I know he does it.
Hopefully 10% to his dad.
Yeah, there you go. I know he's called and asked me a couple of times about names, and they've thrown out the Capitals name, and it was somebody from either past Capital families or the current family, and so it's nice that he is getting some business.
Big, strong network.
Capitals with it now. LaPrade chips it off the boards. And it's going to come all the way down where they're chasing it. I'm going to check point streak again and see if we're losing our mind here. Or now they fixed it. So Charles Burnell with the goal, assisted by Bellis, just like Scotty said. That's going to be icing. And they fixed it there. We certainly hope Beckett gets the puck a few more times as he's setting on two goals for the evening.
First game tomorrow, 8 bells sharp.
8:30 tomorrow morning. So I just heard from some of the players during that intermission. They want to know why I make them get up so early. I said, well, do the math. You can't sleep in much longer. You still got to get here, get warmed up, hour before the game, usually hour and 15. So I told them I'd let them sleep in an extra 15 minutes. And 8:30 game, any way you look at it, it's you're going to be getting up early.
You know what? Tell them, give them what they want. Make them half dress at the hotel.
Oh, shit. Scotty, I remember rolling into somewhere with you, Mason City somewhere, and they were dressing on the bus, I do believe. I think we rolled in 15 minutes before a game started. I'm not sure. I think it was Tyler at one time. Shot a net save. Probably the same game we lost up there, and they had a late night practice when they got home.
About the only time we lost up there then.
It'll be fun to go up to Mason City, and they're getting a brand new arena built in the mall, and it'll be fun to go up there and see you play in a new arena this year.
Heard some conversation on that Wednesday. I've heard the place looks fantastic.
Shot went high.
We have a chance to maybe play in it?
Yeah, I don't know the latest, but we go our first road trip up there. Will be the 14th of December, and I haven't heard that we're not playing in there.
We're there for two?
Up and back.
Oh, it's the bus trip.
Yeah, bus trip, yeah. Well, Scotty, you might be up there for two. We might somebody might just leave your ass up there.
Two dozen, maybe.
Nothing much going on the ice back and forth as Capitals are doing a good job killing this penalty. Back to 5-on-5 action. Flyers pick it up, chip it off the boards. Picked off by Drake Davison and shot on net save.
Well, we took control of this game. Nice finish that second period and a quick start. Exactly what we needed here.
Face off to the glove side of the Flyers goaltender.
Where's that breeze coming from, Tony?
I don't know. Jackson Webb with the face off. Wins the face off. Back to Bellis. Trickled out. Puck comes up through center ice. Well, I'm surprised. It is pretty warm in this. The players say it's hotter than heck out there on the ice, but I'm not complaining. I've felt warm all night long. So, Puck goes on net. Not really a shot on net. Wadden just going to cover it up. 9:34 left in the third. 4-0 hockey game.
I don't want to say anything here, but so far 5 periods in the books on defensive-wise. Yeah.
Face off to the stick side of Wadden. Flyers win the face off. They draw it off on the left-hand side of the ice. Down in deep to play it. Carbomb. Nope, that's not Carbomb.
Mazikowski.
Maslow. And the play goes out. We're supposed to expect a phone call from Tony D tonight.
From Tony D? Well, we might expect one, but I ain't answering. Tell him the RV will be locked up.
Locked up.
In the warehouse. Without anything to do with him.
We love you, Tony D. Capitals win the faceoff on the far side. Down in deep, Maslow with it. Down in behind his own goaltender, Wadden. And the puck comes free, back out to center ice. Maslow with it, in behind his own goaltender again. The Capitals trying to break it out, bringing it our direction. Seems like it's been a little while since it's been down this way. Brunell was the last one to come down and get a scoring chance, and he buried it. On the far side to play it, Baxter. It's hard on our eyes watching the play down there the whole time, Scotty. We need it down here so we get a better focus on the game.
I agree with you. We've done a nice job in that D zone, though, Tony. Kids aren't throwing the pucks around. They're at least going stick to stick. They went up to the wing once, back to the D. So I appreciate when they're not throwing it around, just making poor decisions or leaving pressure, leaving impatient with the puck, trying to make something happen. It's not always open.
Capitals with it over on the far side. Kept in at the blue line. And sorry, folks, pucks left to playing surface. .757 left their third period, 4-0 hockey game.
Tone, what'd you guys eat on the way up today?
We ate once we got here, went to Subway. They did a fantastic job, and, hats off to Subway here. Most of the time they comp our bus driver, which is really nice, but they comped all the coaches, myself, and the bus driver today. So sent them a tweet out thanking them on Twitter, and, not too many companies do that anymore in this day and age, and, thanks to Subway, they took care of us. That's why we keep going back. We eat at Subway quite often. So,
back in the day when me dressing and Bakes were on the bus, it was more McDonald's in the morning for breakfast. That one in Stewart we hit quite a bit.
Yep.
And we hit the one in Mason City, I remember one time, and they wouldn't comp the bus driver or the coaches. We load the kids back up in the bus. Then they came back out trying to get us to come back in. I said,
we're done.
My bad.
Yep. We're going to get a tripping call on the Flyers. And we'll give Capitals. Look for that logo.
Next time the Krugers are on the camera schedule, I'll have that ice cream in tone, be able to comment.
Yes.
Well, definitely a strawberry guy, so I'm going to follow your lead there right out of the chute. Skinny, I'm sure we'll have some chocolate just so we have it.
Well, they make a little pint size of strawberry, and then they make the quart size, but the pint size is plenty, and it is so good. Capitals with it now, down in deep. Power play unit out there, Gabe Myers with it. He is going to sleep well tonight. On the far side to play it is DiCarlo. DiCarlo has it. Left there from Myers. Fires it, shot towards net. Brunell sitting there on the doorstep on the far side. Bellis fires it. Shoulder saved by the goaltender. Steered off into the corner. Back to play it is Bellis. DiCarlo sent the pass to him. And the puck comes out all the way out to center ice. Brunell keeping with it, and he's going to get a penalty here. I think he's going to get a hooking call. And he did get a hook. Nice call by the referee. He did get a hook in there. Brunell playing hard up against the boards. And he's going to take a two-minute break. Play 4-on-4 hockey.
You got a little drama over there? Or stick upstairs maybe? I don't know.
What do you think happened? You're still talking about it.
Well, maybe Charles stick it up in that kid's chin.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Or maybe not. I don't know. Seems to be okay now, but who knows what the refs are talking about.
Faceoff outside the Flyer zone. Capitals win lose the faceoff. 4-on-4 hockey. I like 4-on-4 hockey. I certainly like what they're doing in the NHL overtime, 3-on-3 hockey.
Well, that's a fast game.
Ooh, that is a fast game.
You can get exposed quick.
Capitals bring it down. Couldn't hang on to it. Cooper with it. Couldn't hang on to it. And he's back to play it at center ice. Flyers bring it down all the way down and behind the goaltender for Wadden. Left there for Maslow. Here comes Capitals back the other direction. Baxter with it. Baxter all the way down. Oh. He's Capitals with it now. Right out in front. Shot. Save!
Nice pass out to Cooper to Adams with a little redirect. So, yeah. Well, looks like someone's bleeding out there.
Somebody's bleeding out there. Got a little blood on the ice to our left. That was not from the Brunel. Brunel was further down the ice than that, but there's definitely some blood on the ice. Did not see that earlier.
Who's your NHL team, Tom?
You know what? I got been a Colorado Avalanche for a long time, and boy, they've been hot. I think they're still got the hottest record right now in the NHL. Coach Springs Sabres were up there too, but they've taken a couple of tough losses here lately.
Yeah, your Avalanche is down 3-0 to Phoenix in the
they got
top of the third going on. Avalanche has had a great start. Heard their poor fans, that altitude TV channel's been blacked out.
Yes.
And there's been a lot of complaining and bitching about that.
But I miss that.
Stuff happens. I've been rooting for the Minnesota Wild. They were up on those Stanley Cup champion Blues 3-2 and end up losing 4-3 in OT.
They've had a tough start of the season. And
they have.
Capitals with it back out to center ice. Logsdon with it. Logsdon on the far side. Capitals dump it in. That was Bellis dumped it in. Picked off by the Flyers. 19 seconds remaining on the penalty kill for the Capitals. 4:40 remaining in the third period here. Flyers with it down below the goal line. Shot towards the net and just went wide of Wadden. Bouncing puck loose.
Tom, on Point Street, what'd you have for shots after two? Or
so far? I don't think they're doing it.
And no, we had quite a few shots the first and maybe late second and a little now. But I think Wadden's seen
that
they
did
many.
It.
But could be wrong. Just observance.
Capitals out shooting the Flyers 32-17. Okay. 32-17.
Yeah, this young man for the Fremont has had a good game today.
It doesn't seem like he's faced that many here lately, so.
First period he got hammered pretty strong.
Capitals with it now right up through center ice. Got a takedown, no call.
A little wrestling.
Yep. Oh, and Brunel goes in with a hard hit.
Nice and clean, kept the hands down. No problem for that. Nice step up there by a D-man there. Didn't see who that was.
And now
DiCarlo.
Going to get a whistle.
Got somebody on there.
3:48 left there. We're going to get a whistle and going to go talk to the Capitals bench. Too many men on the ice, maybe?
Didn't catch it. Didn't see it.
I didn't see it either.
I didn't see it before. Don't see it after.
Uh-uh. And I didn't see the hand signal from the ref, so I don't know. Well, needless to say.
It's in a no-good in the box to cover, it looks like. I'll see if it is too many men on the ice. That was the signal.
We'll be back on the Des Moines Printing penalty kill.
Had Tyler start this business, Tony? Or he buy this business? Get
so
into it?
Tyler and a roommate or a buddy from college, there's three of them that started Blue Frog Marketing and Printing. And one of the guys stepped out, and Tyler and the other guy took over. Here about this time last year, year before, maybe five, 3 years, time flies, Tyler ended up buying they split the company in half, Blue Frog Marketing on one side and split the other side to Des Moines Printing. And Tyler bought the Des Moines Printing side I gotta decline that. Sorry, Kelly. My wife's trying to call me. I'll call you back in 3 minutes. I don't know if she heard me. I just said that. So anyway, Tyler bought the Des Moines Printing side of it and trying to make a go of it, and he's done pretty well with it so far. So
good for him.
This is their third building they've been in since they started. They started out of the home. Tyler used to work out of the house when they first started, and then they were down in the old Colonial Bakery area down there.
Oh, sure, down by 2nd Avenue.
Yep, and then they moved out to Waukee and moved from that building about a year ago. So it is growing. 2:28 left in the third period, 4-0 hockey game.
40 seconds left in this penalty kill.
Puck goes all the way up through center ice. Dumped down in deep, chasing after it. Maslow. Shot on net, saved by Wadden, and he's just going to hang on to it. 2:12 left in the third period. 24 seconds left on the penalty for the Capitals. Let's see if they actually put that up there and see what the penalty was for. I think it was too many men on the ice.
Tony, I like these Bucks games starting at 6:30.
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
I love them.
Oh, I think it's awesome move.
The Capitals took a bench minor coach.
Somebody had a comment.
Just had a comment they didn't like out there, so not sure who it did. Who was it, but...
God, if I guess, it's got to be Stanny. I mean,
yeah. Oh shit.
Who'd you guess? D. Elliott ain't saying anything. I'm thinking a bunch.
I'm gonna say Coach Marion.
They heard it from Des Moines.
Yes, that's who I'm gonna put my money on. And yeah. Coach Marion's not even here anymore, but we'll blame it on him. He's been teed up a few times. Bless his heart. Never his fault. Yeah, it was. He would be the first to admit it was his fault. 1:26 remaining in the period. And the puck's down and the Capitals in the ring. Capitals working on the penalty kill. Back to 5-on-5 hockey as soon as I say that. We'll blame it on Coach Himmelson. He's not here.
It was him. He's a loudmouth too.
Puck goes all the way down and that's going to be icing on the Flyers. 1:06 remaining in the third.
Well, it's like a good start to the season.
Yeah. Man.
Got... two wins in the books, and first day is over. Now we worry about second day.
Yep.
Early start, early rise here.
Yep. Big test again tomorrow. I think each day is a big test for the Capitals, and just get by one, and it'll be a very big test next weekend, three games. But these guys are young. Like I say, Chaney Smith, I think, has got him in great shape. Shot off the backboard. His goalie comes out and saves it. Scotty, I don't know if you've ever been to the dry land, but they're pretty intense. I sure the hell wouldn't want to do them.
Yeah. I've seen a couple of them in my day, just watching the boys after practice. Seeing Joe and Clark down there at different times, you bet.
Capitals win the faceoff. You know, Chaney Smith got a young boy. Chaney and his girlfriend at the time got married, and then they have kids, and now they have a little boy growing up, and he's got a pair of skates on. So,
all right.
Chaney, I told him, I said, we got the first rights to him when he comes out to high school. So, and he's loving it. One of the Capitals' dads, I think the Baxters gave him a pair of skates, or maybe the young family. Somebody from the Capitals gave the young boy a pair of skates, and then somebody else said, tell them not to buy any equipment. I got all the equipment in the world for them. So it's nice to see our Capital family step up like they always do. Shot on net. Bar down goal. And Noga with his first goal of the season, I do believe.
That was a nice shot. He came across up high in the slot there.
I don't know
if he caught the goalie off guard or not. But I tell you what.
Noga pants.
Yeah, you shoot those pucks by the head, left or right side of the head there. It's tough for them to catch and get a glove up that high that quick. And maybe a little bar down again as well, huh?
Yeah, bar down. And, boy, I tell you what, that makes you proud to wear that 38 jersey. We saw that plenty of times.
Oh, I know his brother never scored goals like that, Tony.
Five-zero hockey game, and that's going to pretty much do it. Scott, thanks for running the camera. Thanks for going on the air tonight. You made it easier for me.
Anytime, Tony.
We're going to get Rob Paulus back here one of these days, and he's always fun to go on the air with.
No doubt about it.
And that's going to do it. We're out of here, guys. We'll let you see the handshake. Capitals pick up a 5-0 win. Congratulations to Wadden down there. Great win for Wadden. Both goalies got a shutout tonight, right?
Six periods.
Yeah.
Down on the mileage. Yeah.
So,
it's good defense.
Bernie with a shutout in the varsity game and Wadden with a shutout for the JV game. And got a lot of goalies on hand this year. We might see, don't know, but probably see a couple new goalies tomorrow. So hats off to the Capitals. Congratulations. Thanks, Scott. I'm going to pick up and get out of here. Thanks.
See you, bud. Hey, don't forget to call Kelly.
All right, yeah, thank you. I'll call Kelly here shortly.